Good evening. My name is Ty Smith. I'm the Director of Coaching at Columbus Express Soccer Club, and welcome to the 2021 and 2022 Pre-Academy Kickoff Meeting. This video and any printouts or handouts will be available at columbusexpress.com/meeting. If you have any questions, please send an email to ty@columbusexpress.com, ej@columbusexpress.com, or rachel@columbusexpress.com, and we'll be sure to answer it. A little bit about Columbus Express Soccer Club. So for over 40 years, Columbus Express has been Indiana's premier soccer experience. We are a competitive soccer club. We offer opportunities for players ages 6 to 19 years old. We are a member of Indiana Youth Soccer and U.S. Youth Soccer, and the club is growing. We have players from 12 different counties within Indiana. The mission of the club is to prepare youth for the future by developing important life skills through the game of soccer. And the vision that we have is to build on the club's rich history and be the best soccer club in South Central Indiana by attracting a diverse group of young players, utilizing player-centered instruction, and maintaining a culture of excellence and inclusivity, all of which positively impacts our players, families, and communities. Player safety is our number one priority within the club. So whether that's there's a concussion, anytime that we suspect there's going to a concussion, we're going to sit players out. A two deep policy so that no coach or player is left by themselves. Anti-bullying procedures and protocols, weather and lightning policies and protocols, and then COVID-19 imperatives that are in conjunction with Indiana Soccer. Some of our club partners include Columbus Auto Group. They've helped out with providing training vest for all the players, Adidas, which is our official club sponsor, and Soccer Village, which is our uniform supplier. Some of the values or the guiding principles that we have within Columbus Express: education, so valuing the lifelong process of learning, discipline, this is how we believe goals become accomplishments, relationships, so building rapport and trust within the team and one another, and also building unity with the team. And effort, so being hardworking, devoting that energy to improve and pursue excellence. Some of our key components of how we carry out our goals and how we develop players and teams and people: player development, coaching, parent engagement, and competition. So within player development, that means we have an age-specific curriculum. We're looking to provide informal and formal educational opportunities to our players, helping them reach their goals as soccer players. Coaching. All of our coaches are expected to adhere to our curriculum, which is a training plan that we have to ensure that we have purposeful and meaningful training sessions that align to long-term athlete development. Parent engagement. We want to help parents help their players, whether that's helping educate on the processes or being better influences within and outside of the game. And then lastly, competition. So providing a competitive training environment that rewards players that are competing to improve. As far as the organization goes, we are led by a board of directors and an executive board. My role as the director of coaching, I oversee all the soccer that is played, whether that's the vision, the methodology, the style, and then a lot of the admin portion. That is through my role, but also the administrative side. Jenny Carlson will help out with a ton of that. Within just the pre-academy facet. We're going to have EJ Young. He will be the boys pre-academy director, and Rachel Hutchinson, she is the girls academy and pre-academy director. And within that, we'll also have a pre-academy staff. So just so you can see some of the faces that go with the name. So Jenny Carlson, our club administrator, Ty Smith, he'll be the director of coaching. Drew Little, our seniors director. Dylan Andrew, who was previously our academy director, he's now stepping into our juniors director role. Rachel Hutchinson, she's our girls academy and pre-academy director. Ike DeClue, he is our boys academy director. EJ Young is our boys pre-academy director. And Mike Adkins-Estes is our new goalkeeping director. So the pre-academy coaches on staff, EJ Young, he'll be leading the boys pre-academy, but J.R. Honeas, he'll be helping out as well with Dave Bush on the boys' side. Rachel Hutchinson will have the girls' pre-academy group. In regards to the pre-academy, we are focused on 4 versus 4. Everything goes by your birth year, but we do group the 2014s and 2015s together in the pre-academy age group. The entire focus will be on 4 versus 4. The entire focus will be on small-sided. Training will likely be 1s versus 1s, 2 versus 2, 3 versus 3s, and then some 4 versus 4. As we look at where the pre-academy starts and goes through our player pathway, this is the introduction stage. So the 7 and 8 year olds, these 4 versus 4 players, what we're going to be working on is skill acquisition. So technical mastery, learning the fundamentals of manipulating the ball, how to attack, how to defend individually. We want to build as many tools within the player's toolbox as possible so that we can continue to progress through the stages. All right, so everything will be a lot of individual decision making, how they manipulate the ball, how they can move the ball, how they can protect the ball, a lot of attacking focus in the pre-academy stages. Our seasonal training structure, because we have a lot of players and families are new, we will go from August to October. That will be our fall season. November, December, January, and February, we are off. We will have some additional opportunities with our low-cost futsal league during these months, but we think it's important that kids do other things, that they participate in other sports. We will have different opportunities for them throughout those seasons, but that winter time, they're off. And then we will start back up usually the week after spring break in March, and we'll conclude in June. All training will be held at the Richard Wise Soccer Complex. It is one of the best facilities in the Midwest. The only thing that we ask is we want parents to stay in the parking lot area during training sessions. We don't want you on the sidelines of the fields, just from creating a professional player environment. But also, there's a lot of people that come through the park, so we want to ensure that we're always keeping players safe. And the only people that should be around our kids at the time are the coaches and staff. So for the pre-academy age group, they will be training on these fields A, B, C, and D, located behind Parkside Elementary. So there's really two key areas that parents can park or hang out. The parking lot off of Parkside Drive, and I believe the intersection is Arlington. That's a good place. A lot of our parents park in there. It's a gravel lot, but please be careful. It is a busy lot, and the sight lines aren't great there. But also off of Whitney Court, just north of Field 7 and 8, there is a pathway between Field 8 and Field 20 that you could walk to A, B, C, and D. Training attire, all the players are expected to wear their black training uniform. If you don't have your training uniform in yet, just please wear dark colors. All right. Each player will be given a green vest and an orange vest. This is what you will bring to training. In that white badge area where it says Columbus Express Soccer Club, you are expected to write your player's name in there. Each player will be given this vest. They will be responsible for bringing it to and from training and being prepared to put it on at training. So if you're a returning player and you need a new vest, please let us know. But if you have a vest, we want you to continue to use it. If the name has fallen off, or we can get that replaced and get that fixed, or if you were given too big of a size or you've outgrown yours, let us know and we'll get you a new one. As far as game uniforms, the home jerseys are white with white socks. The navy shorts will be consistent between the home and away. And then the away jerseys are the orange jerseys with the navy socks. You must bring everything to each game. The way that the pre-academy and academy age groups work, typically you'll play a game, you may play one or two games in a day or in an afternoon. And one game you might be in wearing the white jersey, and the next game you might be wearing the orange jersey. Coaches will relay what jersey you're wearing, but you need to bring everything to your games. Okay, both socks, both jerseys. Be prepared, please. We've had kids show up and not get to play because they didn't bring their jerseys, and mom and dad are upset and yelling at the kid, and the kid's upset, and then the coach is upset. So it's not a good look. Not something we want to keep dealing with. So make sure that you're prepared and accountable for your equipment. Communication. So how we relay messages, how we get things out to you in a timely manner. The biggest resource that we have, the best resource we have for communication, is Team Snap. So everybody should have received an invitation for Team Snap. If you didn't, please check your spam, check your junk email. But you would have signed up for tryouts with your Team Snap. So make sure that if you have that invitation, you're accessing the app, you've downloaded it, you've accepted the invitation. If you haven't, let us know. We'll try to figure out what steps we're missing. But this will be our primary source of communication. The app's great. It's got all your schedule in it. You can sync it to your calendars. We'll send out weather delays or questions on that. We'll send out the game schedule, the training schedule. Any questions we need, anything that we need to adjust, we'll do through Team Snap. Typically, any major announcements or new things we'll also send out through social media. So we do have Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. We don't tweet a whole lot, but we have it. So if you don't follow us, we encourage you to follow us. We also have a YouTube page, which we need more subscribers, so please subscribe to that. Just Google it, because until we get more subscribers, we can't be youtube.com/Columbus Express. But on the YouTube page, there are some match highlights. There are resources for individual player development, tips. This video will be on there. So check us out, please. Key contacts. These will all be uploaded into Team Snap, with the exception of myself and Jenny. But if you have any questions, feel free to give myself, Jenny, EJ, or Rachel send us an email or text or call. And yes, parents, we do train and play in the rain. So your kid's going to get wet. Be prepared for that. Unless there's a monsoon, unless there's lightning and thunder or a foot of snow, we're going to try to train. So we're going to play games in the rain. We're going to practice in the rain. I would recommend putting a trash bag in your child's soccer bag so that you can always throw the trash bag over the backpack to keep everything dry and safe. But we will train. I do not want to have text messages. Your coaches do not want text messages at 9 a.m. because there's a cloud in the sky. Hey, are we practicing today? We understand you have busy lives. You have other children. You have things to do. The way that Southern Indiana weather works, we're going to try to adhere to a 2 hour, 3 hour window before training to make an announcement. But some of that stuff happens rather quickly. So there may be times that we get out there and it lightings and we have to cancel out of the fields, but we're going to do our best to make calls on weather. So please do not be asking in the morning if we're having practice or not. We will let you know. Attendance policy. Express soccer should be your extracurricular priority in the fall and the spring season. We understand kids play other sports. You have other things going on in your life, but from a standpoint of people are making this their priority, they're showing up to training, they're scheduling around what we're trying to do. We ask that you're at everything as to the best of your ability. Work with coaches if there is a conflict. You know that there's your aunt or uncle is getting married. You can't be there that day. Let us know, right? And attendance is expected. Your playing time could be reduced if you're not in attendance. So players that are at practice, those are going to be the players that play. But we're also going to reward the people that have the best attendance. So whether that be tickets to a professional game that's, you know, Racing Louisville for the ladies' professional team down there, or FC Cincinnati, Indy 11, or Louisville City, or we are going to get a kid their favorite club team jersey, or we're going to provide them with some new equipment. We're gonna acknowledge those kids that have the best attendance, right? So make sure that if you know you're not going to be at a game, you're not going to be at training, let your coach know as soon as possible. We might need to change the training times. We might have to combine groups. We might have to find replacement players if it's a game. Please just do that. That's just common courtesy and respect towards your teammates, your coaches, and the other families. And failure to relay these absences of training, we have removed people from the club for this. We feel that it's very disrespectful not to show up. We feel that it's very disrespectful not to communicate. You know, parents, if you did this at your job, if you didn't show up without communicating at your job, you would be fired. We want to kind of instill that accountability within the kids, within you, the parents, and treat it the same way. So please, please just relay any absences. Now, as we get into the parents, again, we want to try to influence and help and educate the parents. So some of our expectations, can we be respectful towards all the players, the coaches, and the teams? Typically in the pre-academy age group, there's no referees. Coaches are going to police the game. We don't care who wins or loses in this game. We have certain things that we're going to be trying to accomplish in each game. And sometimes in soccer, the team that wins is not the best team, or the team that's winning at 4-4 is not set up to win at 11-11. So we have some key things that we're going to focus on to make sure that kids are doing what they need to do to be successful in the future. But please be respectful towards everybody. Be positive influences that support the players. And then, you know, the playing time and positions in pre-academy, we're going to adjust a lot of kids. There's going to be a lot of playing time for everybody. So just please, let's not have those discussions with your coaches. Parents, you're not permitted on the field sidelines during training, and you're not permitted on the team sidelines during games. And then stay current with all your financial agreements and fees. Here's a video I found quite entertaining.
Sports. With them, kids develop teamwork, physical skills, and an appreciation for jock jams. But there's a distressing movement in youth sports, and it's parental misconduct.
Nearly every weekend, bad behavior by mom and dads caught on tape. These parents getting into it at a high school basketball game. And what about this out-of-control dad, so fearful his son's losing a wrestling match, he shoves a 10-year-old clear across the ring?
That's insane. The only way any of that is okay is when it's played to this music. I was wrong. It's still terrible. A study with over 3,000 children surveyed shows 74% of children have seen out-of-control adults at their games, 37% have witnessed parents yelling at their kids, and 4% have seen violent conduct from adults. We could do better than that. Look, it's easy to get overexcited at these games, seeing that youth sports is now a $15 billion a year industry. That's just shy of all the Marvel films combined. So what happens when such a popular recreation and hobby evolves at this violent level?
The 2011 Tustin Red Cobras Pop Warner football team went undefeated in the regular season. John Zanelli, then an assistant coach for the team of 10 and 11-year-olds, now says other coaches on the team offered the boys $20 cash bounties for big hits on opposing players.
Bounties?
It's youth league.
Most of those don't even keep score. And let's not forget that it's not just the players that are kids, but the officials as well. Take the 14-year-old volunteer referee from Cleveland who was so verbally abused by adults that she reached out on the youth league's social media page asking them to stop. Obviously, not every parent hulks out at their kids' games. But what makes a grown-up act out in this way?
Fear, ego, and greed. As a parent, I have a tremendous fear today, more than ever, that my child would not be number one.
Ego?
Ego? I could have been a major league player.
They're living through their kids?
Absolutely. The third thing?
Greed?
Greed, you got it. My child's going to make some of that big money. Going to get into the major leagues, million-dollar contracts, and that's where it crosses over the line. Kids, you ask kids if they want that? Nah. What kids want is fun.
So what are people doing to combat this kind of behavior? Check out this program from the Washington, D.C. area.
That may seem like a typical kids' soccer game, but did you notice there was only one voice being heard on the field? The coach. No parents yelling at their kids or yelling at the ref.
And this weekend, about 6,000 local kids will play soccer with no unsolicited sideline coaching from their parents.
We all get excited and love to cheer our kids on. But if you're the one out there making a scene, the real question is, why are you getting so intense? What's the end game for you if we act this way? Our kids may roll their eyes at mom jeans and dad jokes, but the reality is they look up to us. We are the first and last examples in their lives, and seeing how we react in the real world speaks volumes to them. Because in the end, all we need is to treat each other with a little. Plus, you don't want to get clapped back like this guy did.
You're still the worst flopper in the NBA.
Thanks for watching. For Life Crunch, I'm Trey Warner, sharing news your family can chew.
So how can parents help? We're going to ask you to be supportive but fair. So help your kids when they're struggling with things, but also give them some encouragement when they need it. Encourage them to work on some things that they're not so strong at. Help them get the proper sleep and nutrition, to bed at a certain time. You're going to provide most of the meals. Make sure they're serving them as an athlete. Transportation, whether that is you providing the ride, you organizing the ride, you reminding them to get on their bike and pedal to practice. A lot of kids are doing a lot of different things right now. So set those priorities, balance the activities, and then focus on the process of learning, which the process of learning is also the process of failing. So making mistakes, learning from those mistakes, trying again, trying again, trying again. And then I think it is fair to praise or criticize effort. So effort and your attitude, those are things that are under the player, individual player's control. So a lot of the acknowledgement of success for children at this age is how hard did they play. It's not how many goals, not how many connected passes, not how many interceptions. It's how hard did I play. And if we can focus on players playing hard and putting forth a good effort, then we're in a good spot. The individual development plans, those are things for in the future that we will start slightly introducing in the academy age group. Nutrition. So this is a big focus for us moving forward. We did create a nutritional guide, so it is available on our website. We just ask that you take a look at it. It gives you some options and some choices and some things you can do for snacks and maybe different alternatives. We're going to look at some of our coaching. So our objectives as coaches, we want to have the player safety is number one priority, as we mentioned, but also health promotion. So we want players that are lifelong athletes, whether it's our sport or another. We want kids that continue to play throughout their 30s, 40s, 50s. But then we want to organize the sessions and the seasons, creating those opportunities to succeed and fail, which we believe is learning, and then following the appropriate training objectives. It's also important for us to provide unconditional attention to all the players. So realizing that sometimes we might be the only person that acknowledges a kid during the day, that gives them a pat on the back. But also there may be, this is the thing that the kids look forward to the most. And if us as coaches, who can be very important aspects in their lives, aren't acknowledging those kids or giving them the time of day, like, that can be very detrimental. So our curriculum is how and what we're trying to develop within our players. So from the style, the principles, the methods, the objectives, everything is very detailed in this, and our coaches have certain specific activities and things they're trying to get out of every session. And our fundamentals for coaches. We want our coaches to be energetic, bring enthusiasm to the game or in the session, be competent, so know they have knowledge of what they're teaching, action, less talking, more playing, and then training and challenging the top kids in that group. Because if we can challenge the top groups, the top kids, the top players, everybody is going to get challenged. Making sessions realistic with changing transitional moments, decision-making, changing spaces, and then planning, organizing, and delivering. So taking time to think about what we're going to do at training or what our game's going to look like. And then the common theme that we've had for the last few seasons is empathy. So just understanding the players and trying to relate to them and understanding their individual situations, what home's like, what they're dealing with at school, what makes them tick, just so that we can build that trust and connect with them and establish the environment that's going to be conducive for success. And then the last few things we're going to look at is the players. So one thing is the standards and the expectations. We want them to be respectful, accountable towards themselves and others. So be professional, act with dignity and honor. We understand they're kids, they're young kids, very young kids, but we have certain things we want them to do. Set their bags up when they get to training, be nice to each other. Coaches are talking, make sure that you're listening. And then making sure as parents you're helping guide them with some of these, the nutrition piece, the hydration piece, the sleep, the hygiene. Some of your kids need to bathe more often, they're stinky. And then the professional, the preparation towards performance. So are they ready to play? Do they have everything they need, their equipment, their ball, things like that. And then being committed towards improving on their own time. So practicing at home, whether it's through certain games that we introduce to them, or it's different activities, or just playing with others in different sports, but then also improving with us. And a theme you'll hear us talk about or exercise or part of training is pro time. So when you arrive, that your pro time starts. So think of it like 15 minutes before practice, you get there. It's free play. It's detailed training. It could be playing 2 versus 2 with a buddy. It could be you and another buddy passing and moving. But these are opportunities to get better, and we want our kids to take care of that. So you should be arriving 15, 20 minutes before training session anyway. So as you get there, lay your bags down and let's jump into pro time. Player development. So the players that have seen the biggest improvements since I've been here, I started in the club in February 2017, but the players have seen the biggest jumps. They're always training at home and they are always at our trainings. So it's attendance and just being there and then being active on their own at home. So one tool we've purchased for all the players in the club is Techni. It's an app. It has individual development programming, different challenges and activities. We will send you guys login information for this in the next few weeks so that you have access to doing it and working on it. And some of our resources that we have on our website, there's Q-Work, there's some other individual programming on there. Our YouTube page has stuff. And then the Techni app, that's a good place for you to have detailed, curated workouts for your athlete. Briefly, just a few key dates and we'll get out of here. August 16th, we start training. Fall break, October 9th through 17th, we will still have some form of practice. October 16th, we're going to be having Indy 11 night up at Carroll Stadium against Louisville City. We'll have opportunities for players to jump on the field, meet and greet some of the players. And then October 29th, big hit last year, our Halloween Spooktacular. All the kids are going to get in their uniform and practice and play some fun games, and there may be some prizes. Lastly, November 1st, fall training is over. May end before that, but that's the official date that will be done. August 17th and 18th, we are going to have parent practice night. This is going to be an opportunity for the parents to jump out to the fields. I am going to run the training session. You're going to get in. You can go through the same type of activities, the same type of format that our players go through. We're going to offer it two different nights. You're free to do one, you're free to do two, you're free to do none and come and watch. But register online, go to our website. Underneath programs at the menu, there is a parent practice night sign up. We can get ice if you need it after the session, but it's usually a fun time. So as I mentioned previously, if you have any questions, send an email to Ty or EJ or Rachel, and then it's at columbusexpress.com. So we're really excited to get started. Pre-Academy is our last group to get going. Everything went on without a hitch with the juniors and the Academy players. So we're ready to get the rest of the club going, and we're excited for another successful season. So everybody take care, and we will see you tomorrow.